I set out. He said, this is his first time here in our little town. I said, dog, here, let me show you around. He said, well, first of all, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. Yeah. You see it got a hole there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got a big hole in New Orleans, right? And it got a bad rip. Let me start over here. You see, we got a big hole there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powdered during the night that Francis Scott Key sitting watching it right in the CKC. And it got a big rip in New Orleans with Jackson and tugging at the sea. And it fell beside the Alamo, almost fell beside the Texas flag, but she waved on, you know. She got cut in the Chambersville. She got cut again in Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Bogart, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a surface gun. She turned blood red in World War II and hung below a little limb a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She was sick, but she was chosen by her Uncle Sam. She waited upon the ships of the mighty fall, but they did not quit waiting back here at home. In her own mother's land, she's been abused. She's been burned, denied, refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. But she's sitting old in the print there, and but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. But she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, we never let her touch the ground, and we fold it up right. On second thought, I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Stop recording video.